Hello and welcome to this Elections Unlock special, the show that brings you all that's happening in the battle for 2024. All eyes this week are on the national capital because Delhi will be going to the polls with 7 seats on offer. Remember, there is the 6th phase of polling on Saturday. Why is Delhi important? Because Delhi, in a sense, sets the trend often, much like Mumbai, for the overall national picture. In Delhi's case, especially for what will happen across North India. Of these 7 seats, several of them are witnessing key battles in this election, which is why you're having road shows and rallies by all the major leaders in the last 48 hours before elections on Saturday. I want to focus right at the very top on one of those key constituencies, Northeast Delhi, or Yamuna Par as they would call it, where the battle is between Manoj Tiwari, the 2-time BJP MP, and Kanhaiya Kumar, the star candidate of the Congress, the former Jawaharlal Nehru University Students Union President. We focused on Mr. Kanhaiya Kumar yesterday. We caught up with him on the campaign trail. Today, our correspondent Sneha Mordani has caught up with Manoj Tiwari, the man who brings a flavor of Bhojpuri to his campaign. Take a look at Manoj Tiwari on the campaign trail in Delhi.
युवा नेता माना जाते कन्हैया कुमार पहले सक्सेस नहीं हुआ है, लेकिन ये कहा जा रहा है कि इस समय आम आदमी पार्टी और कांग्रेस का गठबंधन है।
इसके कारण आम आदमी पार्टी और कांग्रेस दोनों के कार्यकर्ता रुष्ट हो गए और वो बीजेपी को सपोर्ट कर रहे हैं। देखिए, आम आदमी पार्टी और कांग्रेस का मेल होना ये पार्टी का मेल नहीं है, ये दो व्यक्तियों का मेल है, अरविंद केजरीवाल जी और राहुल गांधी जी, और पार्टी के अंदर कोई एक्सेप्ट नहीं कर रहा।
जो मुख्यमंत्री थे वो 50 दिन से ज्यादा जेल में रहे हैं, एक सिंपैथी फैक्टर जो है वो प्ले कर जाएगा।
कैसी सिंपैथी, आप देखिए यहाँ के लोगों को साफ पानी नहीं मिलता है, बुजुर्गों का पेंशन बंद है, कौन सिंपैथी दे।
तीसरी बार लोगों का भरोसा जीत पाना इतना आसान नहीं है।
नरेंद्र मोदी जी भरोसे का दूसरा नाम है। भरोसा तो टूटा है दिल्ली को, जिन्होंने 25 साल तक लूटा है उनसे। कांग्रेस पहले लूटी, आम आदमी पार्टी आई, आज देखिए दोनों एक हैं। अब लोग पीएम भी बनाएंगे मोदी जी को, और 6 महीना बाद जो दूसरी चाबी है ना दिल्ली सरकार की, वो भी देंगे बीजेपी को। यही समय है, सही समय है, पीएम मोदी दिल्ली में बीजेपी करके देगी और दिल्ली का काम। कौन जानता था कि आम आदमी पार्टी भी कांग्रेस का ही अंग है, आज देखिए सबके सामने आ गई। और उनका कैंडिडेट जो है, ऐसा कैंडिडेट लाए हैं कि उसके प्रति भयानक आक्रोश है। जो उनका कैडर वोट है वो भी अब नहीं दे रहा है, क्योंकि हमको देश के टुकड़े करने की भावना वाले लोग नहीं, घर घर से अफजल जैसे आतंकवादी निकालने वाले लोग नहीं, हमको चाहिए इस क्षेत्र में। यही सब क्षेत्र है जहां दंगे झेले हैं हम सब ने। तो एक आम आदमी पार्टी का पार्षद आया, वो दंगे करवाया, एक को बुला रहे हो टुकड़े टुकड़े गैंग का, वो आतंकवादी निकालता है। अब इस क्षेत्र के लोगों में बहुत आक्रोश है, ये चुनाव बिल्कुल एक तरफा हो गया है, क्योंकि टुकड़े टुकड़े गैंग की भावना को कभी ये क्षेत्र वोट देना तो दूर, उनको बिठाना भी मुश्किल है।
इस क्षेत्र के लोगों के लिए आपका क्या वादा है?
आप अभी आई होंगी सिग्नेचर ब्रिज से, वो सिग्नेचर ब्रिज बना के हमने दिया, मेट्रो 4-5 महीने में ट्रिपल डेकर मेट्रो शुरू कर देंगे। सारी ट्रैफिक कंजेशन था उसको दूर कर दिया है, जो थोड़ी मोड़ी अभी काम बचे हुए है वो भी पूरा हो जाएगा। 14,600 करोड़ का काम कराया हमने इस क्षेत्र में, 5 करोड़ का ही मेरा बजट है।
Okay, let's turn away from Manoj Tiwari's campaign to look at issues on the ground. One of these issues is that of water pollution. Remember, there's a lot of complaint about the way the Yamuna in particular has been toxified over the years. Unfortunately, no one talks about air or water pollution in their campaign speeches. Watch this special report by Sneha Mordani to understand the gravity of the crisis.
Every year, year after year, Delhi grapples with a crisis, that of us breathing in filth. Air pollution, which is a year-long phenomena in the national capital, hits headlines in winters as the one factor contributing to Delhi becoming a gas chamber. Not just air, Delhi also has a massive toxic drain.
This is the Yamuna River, arguably the most polluted river in the entire country. Research has shown that the 22-kilometer stretch of the river, of the Yamuna River in Delhi city, in the national capital, is actually the most toxic. Industrial waste are dumped in it. Elections have come in and gone. Delhi Assembly elections, also Lok Sabha elections. Promises have been made by MPs that they will work in tandem with the Delhi government, with the Haryana government, to clean up the river, clean up the Yamuna. But the results are for us to see. People, in fact, living in this stretch repeatedly talk about how this is a classic example of failed promises, be it any political party, be it any election.
Air pollution and pollution of River Yamuna, most prominently discussed during the Chhath Puja, have fallen off the priority list. Over the past week, Delhiites have been breathing in poor quality of air for 4 days, thanks to dry conditions and dust.
Vayu Pradushan itni bhayankar matra mein hai Delhi mein. Agar aap tulna kare anya mahanagaron se hamare desh mein, vishwa bhar ke mahanagaron mein, to Delhi ka sthan pehle ya dusre number par aata.
The Congress recently said in a press conference that the center is to be blamed for failing to address the city's environment issues, saying that the union government can ensure control on pollution since issues are related to multiple states, promising that it will solve the problem of air and water pollution if the India bloc is voted to power. But there is just no noise around these problems. Should have MP hopefuls not had this on top of their priority list?
This is an important issue of health. This is an important issue of economy. It's not only an issue of environment. And therefore, I am disappointed, as I said, that the issue has not got the kind of attention it should have, because Delhi is suffering from air pollution. Of course, Delhi is also suffering from different environmental issues. But air pollution is number one environmental problem of the city, Delhi NCR, and the member of people who are contesting the election, as well as voters, we should be concerned about this issue and we should be raising this issue.
Air pollution in Delhi is majorly caused by 11 thermal power plants. In spite of strict regulations to follow pollution control norms, these are being violated. Chemical pollution, widespread deforestation, illegal mining and illegal construction in the Aravallis. Existence of about 350 brick kilns around Delhi, mostly in UP and Haryana. Bhalswa, Ghazipur and Okhla, three of Delhi's biggest garbage dumping grounds, also find no mention in campaigns, underscoring the apathy of our netas.
Delhi is a very peculiar city. As I said, you have a municipal corporation, you have a state government, and you have the central government here. And therefore, this is a city where intervention of all three levels of government will be required to solve any major problem. Yes. And solid waste management is a big problem in this city. We don't have land to dump waste now. In fact, all the landfill sites in Delhi are illegal. And I believe that, like air pollution and Yamuna pollution, this is also an issue of the parliament.
Citizens, through their charter of demands, have been asking candidates to talk about these concerns that affect Delhiites the most. But who is listening? In New Delhi, Sneha Murdani for India Today TV.
Okay, from Delhi, let's turn to Haryana, a state that promises an intriguing contest. Because remember, Haryana is one of the states that will have not just Lok Sabha elections on Saturday, but Vidhan Sabha elections later this year. One of the constituencies that's been closely watched in Haryana is Kurukshetra. The BJP candidate here is a former Congress MP, Naveen Jindal, the industrialist, is contesting soon after having switched to the BJP only a few months ago. Pitted against him is an Aam Aadmi Party candidate. The Aam Aadmi Party, Sushil Gupta, is hoping to make a mark here, Haryana being one of the states close to Delhi where the AAP is hoping to expand. And to make things even more interesting, there's Abhay Chautala of the INLD who's hoping to recover some lost ground for his party. A triangular contest is why Kurukshetra is being looked at very closely. Manjeet Sehgal has today's ground report from Kurukshetra.
On the election campaign trail, Kurukshetra has become a hot seat. The city, known historically as the battleground of Mahabharat, is now a witness to a triangular fight between BJP, India Bloc and INLD. As the poll date nears, the campaign pitch becomes shrill, leaving no stones unturned to woo the voter dominated by the Jat community. The sitting MP from Kurukshetra, Nayab Singh, is now the chief minister of the state. BJP decided to give a ticket to a candidate who has recently joined its brigade.
We are on a campaign trail in Kurukshetra Lok Sabha constituency where the BJP nominee and former Kurukshetra MP Naveen Jindal is meeting the people and addressing small gatherings. He is touring to various villages. He joined the Bharatiya Janata Party recently and previously had won twice on a Congress ticket. This is the gathering here.
Industrialist Naveen Jindal has represented Kurukshetra as an MP twice in 2004 and 2009. He was then with Congress. After his 2014 defeat to BJP's Rajkumar Saini, Congress did not give him ticket for Kurukshetra in 2019. Before the election dates were announced, he joined BJP and is back on the roads of Kurukshetra trying to win voters for the party.
We feel that the way we are getting a response from the people, I have contested, this is going to be my fourth time contesting from here. So we are getting tremendous response from the people. So we feel that we are miles ahead.
Naveen Jindal's alleged involvement in the Colgate scam haunts him despite joining BJP. India Bloc candidate Sushil Gupta is an industrialist asking for vote for the broom, leaves no space to attack the Saffron Party and its candidate.
Nayab Singh yahan pe pehle sansad rahe, unka naam logon ne Gayab Singh rakh diya, bilkul kisi gaon ke andar nahi gaye. Naveen Jindal jo yahan se BJP ke pratyashi hain, unke upar khud pradhanmantri ji ne 1,86,00,000 rupaye koila chori ka aarop lagaya. FIR unke upar likhi gayi, 195 crore pe electoral bond ka chanda unhone diya.
Bharatiya Janata Party ki kathpudli ke roop mein kaam karta hai.
On the other side of the triangle stands INLD candidate, grandson of former Deputy Prime Minister Devi Lal's grandson, Abhay Singh Chautala. Once an ally of the Saffron, INLD is now a sworn enemy.
Aaj BJP ki kya halat thi? Aaj jab hamare the, to jitna unka taam jham tha, sara daftar kya ke khada tha. So aadmi bhi nahi keh sakte aap. सो की भी गिनती नहीं है. जितने लोग साथ होते हैं उससे दोगुना पुलिस फोर्स जाती है, तब जा करके बेचारों को कहीं गांव के अंदर कोई बढ़ने देता है.
वोटर्स ऑफ कुरुक्षेत्र वॉच वेरली एज मोर प्रॉमिसेस आर मेड इन द पोल सीजन व्हाइल द पास्ट आर बेरली फुलफिल्ड.
क्या झोपड़ी में रहने वाला व्यक्ति, क्या उनके लिए शिक्षा अभिव्यक्ति है, अधिकार है? क्या रोजगार उनके लिए अधिकार है? हम केवल और केवल आम आदमी की बात करते हैं, केवल मुद्दों से भटक जाते हैं. कुरुक्षेत्र में तो कुछ भी नहीं हुआ और मुद्दे ही मुद्दे हैं.
भारतीय जनता पार्टी ने मांगे रखी थी किसानों की आय दोगुनी करेंगे, वो नहीं कराया. किसान 378 दिन बॉर्डर पे बैठ रहे, 750 किसान मरे, उनका नहीं कुछ कराया. तो जी फिर MSP कानून की गारंटी दी थी, वो नहीं, कमेटी बनाएंगे वो नहीं बनी, आज भी किसान रेले रोक के बैठे हैं।
कुरुक्षेत्र विल डिसाइड इट्स फेट फॉर द नेक्स्ट 5 years ऑन 25 मई। विद मंजीत सहगल फ्रॉम कुरुक्षेत्र हरियाणा, ब्यूरो रिपोर्ट, इंडिया टुडे।
West Bengal is going through polls in a 7-phase election. In every phase, there are constituencies of Bengal going to the polls. In this round, the 6th phase, one of the most closely watched constituencies is Tamluk in East Midnapore. Why? Because the candidate there is Justice Abhijit Gangopadhyay, formerly of the Calcutta High Court, a judge who decided to switch over and join the BJP, a move that has raised several eyebrows. And he's been in controversy again for his attack on Mamata Banerjee, personal attacks. The Election Commission barred him from campaigning for 24 hours. That period got over at 5 p.m. this evening, but the BJP candidate was in Kolkata and chose not to hit the street. Justice Gangopadhyay is seen as one of the star candidates of the BJP in this election, but can he retain this seat for the party? Suryagni Roy brings you this ground report in a 3-pronged fight in Tamluk's Lok Sabha constituency.
BJP candidate for Tamluk Lok Sabha constituency in East Midnapore, retired Justice Abhijit Gangopadhyay, is in the eye of a storm for his derogatory remarks in an election campaign against the Trinamool Supremo Mamata Banerjee.
2000 taka hai lekha patro ke kena hoye giyechilo 2000 টাকায় লেখাপত্রকে কেনা হয়েছিল মমতা ব্যানার্জি, তুমি কত টাকায় বিক্রি হও, তুমি কত টাকায় বিক্রি হও, তোমার হাতে তো 8 লাখ টাকা গুঁজে দিলে একটা চাকরি দাও।
The retired judge of the Calcutta High Court was talking about Sandesh Khali in North 24 Parganas. The Trinamool has lodged a complaint with the Election Commission. The BJP candidate of Tamluk was barred from campaigning for 24 hours by the poll watchdog. Though it ended at 5 p.m. on Wednesday, he chose not to be back in his constituency for the last-minute election campaign.
Election Commission of India, কালকে একটা অর্ডার পাস করেছে, সেটাতে আমার মতো অনেক আনওয়ারেন্টেড কমেন্ট আছে, আমাকে মেলাইন করা হয়েছে এবং আমাকে ডিফেমো করা হয়েছে। নোটিশটাকে চ্যালেঞ্জ করেছি, আমি অর্ডারটাকে চ্যালেঞ্জ করেছি।
Nearly 90 kilometers from Kolkata, Tamluk had been a left stronghold till 2009. As winds changed in favor of the Trinamool Congress, Tamluk became the loyal bastion of the grass flower. This is the region dominated by the Adhikari brothers till they decided to join the BJP. Shuvendu Adhikari and his brother now are working to ensure Abhijit Gangopadhyay's win for the Lotus.
Abhijit Ganguly koi factor nahi hai, wo shadow hai. Lekin ye jo Shuvendu ka garh hai, ye bola jata hai. अभी तक क्या शुभेंदु कुछ प्रूफ कर पाया ये उसका घर है, और अभी इस इलेक्शन में प्रूफ हो जाएगा कौन किसका घर है नहीं है। लेकिन मैं इतना बात बोल सकता हूँ, ममता बनर्जी ने पॉलिटिकल पावर ऑफ अटर्नी शुभेंदु अधिकारी को दिया था इस डिस्ट्रिक्ट के लिए। अभी जनता के सामने आमने सामने मुकाबला है, ममता बनर्जी या शुभेंदु अधिकारी। ममता बनर्जी को चूज करेंगे ईस्ट मिदनापुर के लोग।
61-year-old Abhijit Gangopadhyay faces tough challenges from young candidates put up by both the Trinamool and CPM. ২৮-year-old Debangshu is the singer-lyricist of Khela Ho Be song that became the theme song for the Trinamool in the 2021 assembly election. He is the youngest candidate fielded by his party in the poll fray. At 31, Shayan Banerjee hopes to reclaim the position the left enjoyed in this region. A lawyer by profession, Shayan hopes to attract the youth voter in his favor.
That is the basic intention, to address the key issues and the key problems which the youth of our country is now facing, that is unemployment, underemployment, and the lack of education, lack of schools, universities, etc. Our party is always trying their level best to uplift the youth from the protest march, from the movement, not from a parachute.
Now, all these three individuals have one thing in common, that is, it's the first time that they are contesting the elections for Lok Sabha. On the 4th of June, it's going to be seen who becomes the MP of this particular seat, which used to be a stronghold of the left till 2009. Then it became a stronghold of the Trinamool Congress when Shubhendu Adhikari and his brother were MPs from this particular seat. With camera person Kiranjit, this is Suryagni Roy for India Today, Tomluk.
I'm afraid that's all that we could pack in on the elections unlocked today. Thanks very much for watching. Stay well, stay safe. Keep watching India Today for all the election and news updates. Namaskar.